Hi everybody, Helen the Russian here again. Today I have some time, so I'll record probably a couple, three videos while I have a chance. I don't always have this opportunity. So just a funny story, well, kind of funny, haha, about passengers and their sense of entitlement and the way they treat drivers and specifically women. So, I got a ride request at the Mirage. I mentioned before I really like Mirage. I like the hotel. I always had liked the hotel, and I still do. But they have really well thought out area for the ride share. It's quite well marked inside of the hotel. I know that I've been inside. They actually have prominent signs pointing to the ride share. And outside is quite lovely. It's distinctly separated from the valet area. They actually have benches. It's covered from the elements. And now that it's getting colder, they actually put the heaters out there. And they're lovely, beautifully looking heaters. So it's really nice. Meaning it's really easy for the passengers to find it. It's comfortable for them to be there. And it's easy for drivers to go through the area. So I get the ride request at the Mirage because I troll around quite often for a ride. And I'm all excited. I pull up and it was a pretty slow night. So apart from me, there was only one car for the ride share and no cars for the valet. So valets were just standing and they're chatting to each other. I'm waiting for the passenger to get in and I usually am quite proactive. I don't like to waste time. So if they're not there within about a minute, I call just to make sure they in the right area or they to make sure they're coming, to make sure they know that I'm there. So I call and the guy, well, on the app, the name was Ben, which, you know, could be anything. When the guy answers from the accent, just like many people can tell that I have Eastern European accent, I can tell where Ben is from. And Ben is from a subcontinent that is quite, well, I'm not gonna say famous, infamous, for the culture where they don't consider women anything, well, anybody really, and don't treat them nice. That it's been well documented all over the news. In fact, that they had a horrific case of rape on a bus just, I think, 3 years ago that was well publicized. Anyhow, that's all irrelevant. So Ben answers and I tell him that I'm his Uber driver and I'm waiting for him and he goes, yes, yes, we're here outside. Main lobby. I go, well, Ben, you need to be at the North Valet. That's where the rideshare pickup is. Ben goes back at me. Yes, we're in the main lobby. I can't see you. I go, Ben, you won't see me in the main lobby. I cannot be in the main lobby. We can't go up front. And I'm pretty patient. Like I said, slow night. I wasn't in any hurry. I like the Mirage. You know, the smell is wafting from. I love that smell that they pipe in there. So he goes, okay, we'll be right there. Okay, I hang up, I wait for Ben, he's not there, and now we're getting closer to 5 minutes. So I call again, I go, he answers, I go, Ben, still here. He goes, oh, I don't see you. I says, well, that's because you're not here. As I mentioned earlier, the situation didn't change. Zero cars at the valets still standing in there talking to each other, and that car that was behind me now left. So I'm by myself. There are no people in there either, so it was a really easy situation. I go, well, you don't see me because you're not where you're supposed to be. You know, and I very slowly go North Valet. I know I have an accent, but again, there are signs, and he can ask the staff as well. And he yet again, he goes, well, we're here at the main lobby. You know, and I can see that we're going round and round. I go, Ben, you need to come to North Valet. He goes, okay, we'll be right there. Just like that. I'm not changing anything. And I know some people might accuse me of trying to copy his accent, but it's just a natural thing that happens when you talk about recreate the event. So it's not in any way racist or offensive. I don't mean it that way. So I hang up and now I've been waiting for just over 6 minutes. As we all know, Uber requires, well, both Lyft and Uber require a 5 minute wait and one phone call. So far I waited over 6 minutes and I made two phone calls. I go, you know what, that's it. So I cancel Ben, rider no show, and I'm just pulling away around that circle and I get a phone call and it's Ben and silly me. I answered. You know, like, genuinely, when I'm giving rides, I'm one of these people, when you sign up for a job, you do the job. You know, when I decided I'm going to give rides, I try to give rides. So I answer and he goes, where are you? We can't see you. I go, well, I'm just pulling away, and I should have looked behind me because, as I found out later, they weren't there still. I go, okay, well, let me make a circle and I'll come back around. So, you know, at the Mirage, it's, those who live in Las Vegas, they know it's an easy circle. It's not that big of a deal. So I circle around, I come back, and for a few seconds, I don't see anyone. And then finally, Ben and his lady friend come out of the door. So they just came out, literally, just. So they come up and I go, are you Ben? And he says, yes. And he goes, well, we didn't see you. I said, well, because you weren't here. And then I said, well, you need to request again. And the woman now goes, well, did you cancel? I go, just like that, in that tone of voice and that aggressively. I go, well, yes, I did, because I waited for over 6 minutes and you weren't here. And Ben is trying to tell me, well, no, we were here, you weren't... I go, Ben, there are cameras. I have a camera in the car, there are cameras at the hotel, there are valets in there. And I was here for a while. Well, he goes, okay, I'm going to order again. Well, the woman is now getting in the car, at the back seat. And I turn around politely, I said, you know, just wait for a second till I get that ride request. We need to make sure that I'm the one who gets it. She goes, well, he's doing it. I said, I realize that, but I need to actually receive it and accept it before I can give you a ride. And then Ben, I guess he did order another Uber, and he goes, oh, but it's not you. I said, I'm sorry, then I can't give you a ride. Well, she starts getting out of the car, and not necessarily even under her breath, because I could hear it loud and clear. She goes, oh, what a fucking bitch. I turned around. Now, after everything that I describe, I've been more than patient with them, and I dealt with that kind of treatment, but I turned around, and I go, what did she just say? Because she started walking away. Well, now Ben, he leans in the car, like half of his body was in the car, from the back, granted. He goes, what did she say? Again, just like that, aggressively and quite unpleasantly. I go, she just called me a fucking bitch. He goes, well, that's because you are a fucking bitch. I said, you know, I mentioned before, I've been in hospitality for decades. Like, I've dealt with it. I go, Ben, close the door. So he did. He had a good sense to just close the door. So I just left. You know, nothing else happened. But here's, I mean, a part of the fact that I was treated badly, which is nothing new. Here is the thing. This is the message to people like Ben. And it may work in his country. And I can tell you, I don't know if he's American citizen now or not. You know, who knows? Maybe not. But here is the thing. It may work in your country. It may work in your community. But on many levels, it does not work here. It certainly does not work in Las Vegas. And I tell you why. Once again, let me spell it out just so you understand what could have happened if I really was a effing bitch and wanted to take it further. Because everything was recorded on the camera. Remember, I have a camera in the car that records inside the car and outside, right? So here's the thing. I am, like many other Uber and Lyft drivers, I'm a local trying to make a living, right? Ben here is a punter, who is a tourist who is visiting Las Vegas. We love tourists. We just love them to come and spend money. We welcome them. It's amazing. Please do come. However, people should behave. They shouldn't be stupid. This kind of behavior annoys everybody in here. So what I could have done, because I'm well versed in various different legal things and language for sure, so I would have gotten out of the car, calmly and politely approached the valets and said, I feel threatened. This guy just threatened me. He was very aggressive and I feel we need to call the police. Again, valets weren't busy. They would not be on Ben's side because he was not valeting. So they knew no tips coming from Ben. Ben's doing Uber and Lyft, right? And I know how to smile pretty and do whatever. I might have even slipped a fiver to the valet. And all of us would have called the cops, who would have turned up, because Mirage is a private property and cops are very careful about hotels and what goes on in there. And no, Ben wouldn't be arrested as a result, but they would give him a bit of trouble. They would have, that he would be questioned extensively, possibly even put in a cruiser for a few minutes until everything is sorted out. So ultimately his night would be ruined. I can promise you that. So, dear tourists, it all goes both ways. I know people complain about Uber and Lyft drivers occasionally. I heard some horror stories, and you know, this is unacceptable. Most of us really trying to go out of our way to make the experience pleasant. You know, we're polite, we're accommodating, we try to help. Well, just treat us the same way. Treat us the way you want to be treated yourself. Don't do things like Ben did, because like I said, if I was feeling really bitchy, I could have ruined Ben's night in a serious way, right? So let's all get along, let's be nice to each other. The rule of thumb, I always say, treat people the way you want to be treated yourself.